So now you understand the importance of using supports, but how do you go about setting up your settings? Today's video will focus on customizing our settings to get the best results from our prints. Orientation, size, and surface area all play an important role in a successful print, but each of these often depend on the type of model you have and the resin being used. It's very important to first establish proper exposure settings for the machine, since this often affects the results of the calibration. I personally prefer using Photoner's Validation Metrics 2 for my preliminary calibration, and will include a link in the description below. It prints quite quickly and allows me to get results fast. If at all possible, it's generally recommended to print with a color that's easily readable, since this can make it easier to gauge the results. I generally always start with the manufacturer recommended settings, then incrementally increase these or decrease them until these two points just barely touch. I will also aim to make sure that as many of these lines are printed as possible. Some slicers offer a variety of save settings for different use cases, and this will be important to set up properly before adding them to your model. In Cheetahbox, for instance, you can choose between light, medium, and heavy supports, and these can vary quite a bit depending on your use case. In order to determine what settings to actually use, especially for model contact points, you could do it the long way or use a model that's similar to Amerlab's. This model is great for figuring out the support thickness for the smallest of the supports as well as their connection lengths. Amerlab's has included a great guide on how to use their calibration test, so I'll include a link in the description as well. Once you've figured out which dimensions work best for your specific resin, you can then begin creating your custom support settings. Seeing as the most difficult settings tend to be for small miniatures, we're going to focus on these for now. To start things off, we'll adjust the bottom exposure number, since this is quite often too high. I found that in most cases I only need to have one or two bottom layers, so long as I increase the bottom layer exposure time. To find out what this should be set to, you're going to refer to your initial test where you printed the validation metrics. I'll normally add 5 to 10 seconds to the initial bottom layer time to help ensure proper adhesion. For the medium and heavy supports, I normally go with the standard recommendation, since this will require more rigidity. We're then going to take the number of the layer height and use this to calculate the platform touch shape thickness. For small prints, this is normally only needs to be one layer, but for larger ones, it'll need to be 2 to 3 times the initial thickness. Generally, the heavier support I need, the thicker I'll make this, so it remains rigid enough not to break or bend. You can see in this example the difference between my different types of supports. The connection point's upper diameter will depend on the results of the Amerlab's test. I normally go slightly higher than the first successful blur dimension, which is between 0.1 to 0.5 millimeters. The lower diameter of the connection point will be the same as the thickness of the pillar. However, some users choose to reduce this number as well. I normally set the connection length to just under the first successful test, just to be safe. The pillar shapes have to support the model and remain rigid enough not to flex while printing. So in this case, I'll normally err on the side of caution. I normally go slightly above the double the thickness when compared to the upper diameter. This helps ensure that the pillar will have a lower likelihood of flexing during the raising and lowering of the build plate. When setting up my heavy supports, I'll set these fairly large, since I'm normally using those for printing props. Models such as those tend to be quite heavy, and the last thing I want is for the print to fail or fall off. When using automated supports, I normally have these set to above 90% with an angle percentage of 35%. With the basic settings for your supports, it's now time to implement these with your first prints. You see the process here.